But just over the road, the dam on the side, there's a new church, and some of these houses on the back are brand new. Obviously, new dumping sites.
America, Japan is too far.
Yeah,
it's far.
Yes, yes. Okay. What are you doing here?
We're just studying.
Yeah?
We're just study
for the university.
Okay.
I've said it before, but it's almost the Wild West out there. I mean, you just go and you do it. I mean, that's why you turn around. I mean, dumping. You're on an outcrop and there's a whole load of stuff just dumped in there. You know, glass, waste, all of that. I mean, it's not great. There's no planning behind it. So, you know, the good it does versus the bad, I don't know. I mean, in a broader sense, a large amount of what we're doing there is controlled by the stock market. Platinum, palladium being pulled out so some investor can stick it in a bank and not use it. So, good or bad? I mean, we need it. But do we need it in that frame? I'd love to rethink it.
I think it can affect the environment if we are not planning properly. But before you do a mining, you must check your environment and also to see where can we protect our environment. Like most of them, they're using chemicals. Mm-hmm. We must have a way, how are we going to keep those chemicals so that they must not affect water. Like you see, there is running water here. It's a Dubatse River, this one, Dubatse River, ne? People are having livestock here and they are drinking the water. So if there is a mining, then we don't protect the environment. Those chemicals, if they go inside the river, you see the livestock are going to die. But you must first have a clear planning. If you can have a clear planning, we do like mining industry a lot and we want it. Bring it, guys. Bring it. We want to work.
Just tell them to shut up. My name is Jaco Pieters. I'm 42 years old, turning 43, and my job title is Chief Safety Officer. If I look at the climate rate currently, and that's not just in South Africa but globally, everything is changing. During this time of year, we should have been in extreme cold in our country, but it is not the case. If I take a graph over the past 3-4 years that's passed, our winter months has been moving with a month every single time. Usually we call it in South Africa the August winds, our August winds since in the past 2 years has moved now to the September-October winds. So mining and the global industry in itself, not only mining, if you look at factories, if you look at power stations, we can name a bunch of them. It is all impacting on the environment of the whole world, and it's obviously part of global warming. I mean, every single piece of property that you choose to mine on, you need to destroy a certain area, which impacts not only on the community itself, but as well as the environment. If you look at animals and birds and bees and insects and all that, they need to be relocated. I've worked on projects where we had a dam where there was a certain type of frog on the verge of being extinct, and we actually had to relocate that whole species to another area to make sure that it survives. So in that side, yes, it's negative. I do agree with it. But on the flip side, the population is growing so fast in the world, not only our country, in the whole world, we still need to keep on living and keep on continuing. But if we do not find another way or method, as an example, instead of generating power through coal, we can generate power through water. If we do not do that a lot faster, the world is going to come to an end. That's the bottom line of it. May not be in our generation, or may not be in my children's generation, but the long and the short of it, it's going to come to an end. I think the misconceptions in mining industry is that people are only there to make money. In my opinion, that's wrong. People are not there to make money. Yes, money is obviously part of it, because if you do not make money, you cannot pay your salaries and your equipment. You cannot go forward. But the misconception to me is, don't only think as a mining industry as I want to richen and fatten my own pocket. The long and the short of it, mining is there. If you don't have, as an example, coal, you can't generate a power station. If you don't have gold, there's no monetary value in the forex industry. If you don't have platinum, the same story. There's a lot of commodities that are needed to keep our livelihoods as we see it alive. Certain parts of mining commodities that are being produced are sitting in the camera that you are currently looking at, pointing at me. You understand what I'm saying? So if mining wasn't there, what would you do? Well, you're going to take a picture of me by means of how. So it's there for a specific reason, to generate your cell phone, to give you power, to generate the fuel that's going to take you guys back to America. Without that, how would you be able to do it? You're not going to climb on a rowboat and come all the way to South Africa. It's not going to happen. So it's there for a good reason. But yes, in the same instance that it is happening, it is destroying the environment.